Okay, art. True art should be beautiful art, something that can be enjoyed, something that calms the spirit, replenishes the soul, lifts us toward our better angels. You see this picture? This is by the president's son. There it is, right up there. This is not true art. This is crap. It's the worst kind of abstract art. It is fraudulent art. It is scam art. It is fake art. It is some kind of bizarre, anti-establishment, left-wing garbage. And Hunter Biden, through his agent, a guy named Georges Berger, according to the New York Post, an ex-con with links to China, they're trying to sell this stuff for $500,000 a painting, okay? Now, you see that picture? This is beautiful, classical art, what is called natural realism. It's real art. It's so good that even our friends of the liberal persuasion love to look at this conservative, traditional, classical art. Who painted this picture? Well, my saintly wife, Judith Pond Kudlow. Highly respected, very successful. In fact, she is one of the leaders of the current movement to go back towards classical art. As I say, natural realism. It is real art. Not only is she a good painter, but she runs a school where she teaches and mentors, and she, of course, is my wife. I make no bones about it. I'm not going to say I'm not prejudiced, but I will say this. Any objective critic will know that this is beautiful art. And any objective critic will know that the stuff Hunter Biden is selling is crap. Okay? So let's have an art fest discussion. Joining us now, Katie Pavlich, editor of thetownhall.com and Fox News contributor, and Guy Benson, Fox News contributor and host of The Guy Benson Show. Okay, kids, you know, I just got to say it. That's my view. His stuff is crap. Look, it's not just my Judy's art. She's part of a beautiful school of beautiful art. Art should be enjoyed. But I just happened to choose her because she just happens to be my bride, and she's in the business. And Katie Pavlich, I'm going to get into a lot of trouble in this segment, but I'll turn it over to you first. Welcome.
Thanks, Larry. It's great to be here. I loved your opening comments about Hunter Biden's art. Mm-hmm. I think that blowing paint through a straw onto a canvas or piece of paper in your pool house is probably the lowest bar in terms of what counts as art these days. And it's certainly not COVID friendly. So I don't know who he's selling these things to, but they're certainly not buying them because they're beautiful or because they're made in a way that can be respected. They're obviously buying these things for an exorbitant amount of money because he's a Biden. And this is a pattern he has had throughout the course of his life as an adult, using the Biden family name to make a lot of money in exchange for access to his father. So the anonymous portion of this, them keeping the buyers anonymous, we don't know who they are, is a question for the ethics of the administration. Now, Hunter Biden doesn't work directly for them, but given the history of selling the Biden name for access for meetings or access to the former vice president when he was not in the Oval Office, there are big questions here about what the motivation is behind the buyers of this, as you would say, crap art.
Yeah, I mean, Guy, the only way you could sell this crap, I mean, not for $500,000, for $1.50. The only way you could sell it for $1.50, it's such garbage, is because you're your father's son and your father happens to be the president. And so Katie is right, and there's ethics issues here which seem to dog Hunter Biden through no matter what he does. I mean, look at this stuff. There's some more of it on the air. $1.50 on a good day, $1.75, Guy. But this is, you know, a political story as well as an art story, is it not?
Well, it's mostly a political story because with art, you know this, Larry, beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Some people prefer stuff that others would say is crap. I'm not going to wade into the art battle here. I am woefully unqualified for that. But I will say, if those paintings were created...
Sorry.
I have no comment, Larry, on the art itself. I do have a comment, which is if his name were Hunter Smith and he put this out there for sale, you know, if he got $50 for it, he'd be lucky. Right. $500,000, confidential. It's like, hey, his last name is Biden. You can give him $500,000. Don't worry, as the buyer, it's fully confidential. Wink. I wonder what people might be trying to purchase with that $500,000. I would say that these paintings are worth $500,000, the same way that Hunter Biden was qualified enough in energy policy to make $83,000 a month from Burisma in Ukraine, right? It's clearly about one thing and not about the actual substance. And Larry, the one thing, this is the way my brain works. When I saw this story, I thought at some point it dawned on me, when do you think the Clintons realized that they couldn't, if they had really wanted to, they didn't have to go through this whole rigmarole of setting up a foundation and, you know, all this charity stuff and all the fundraising. They could have had Hillary with finger paints, sold it confidentiality, you know, on a confidential basis for millions of dollars. And that's how they could have trafficked in this sort of grift that they were accused of. This clearly seems like it is a potential grift. And even Obama's former ethics chief said, yeah, you know, this seems a little fishy.
Katie, just 10 seconds left. Do you think our friend Guy, we love Guy
Larry.
Benson. Katie, doesn't Guy need some help in art appreciation? Seriously, don't we need a little internal class here?
I think he's seeing how enraged you are, Larry, that he doesn't want to make you more angry by taking the wrong side of this issue. But I will take the position that this art is so bad from Hunter Biden that it could have come from the laptop from hell. They could have found it on that laptop. It is so bad.
All right. Guy Benson, thank you.
Larry, okay. I need remedial art classes from your wife.
You'd love it. You'd love her and you'd love the art too. Katie Pavlich, thank you so much. Guy
sure
Benson, thank you so much.